Thank you, mate. Well, police have launched an investigation after shocking footage emerged of a wild brawl at a rugby league game in Sydney's southwest. The incident involved players and fans from the Barala Bears and the Leila Park Cookers, with punishments now looming for both clubs. It's happening right across the sporting codes. For more, let's bring in Stan Sport commentator Craig Foster in Sydney. Craig, good morning to you. Nice to see you this morning. Foz, this kind of violence has no place in any sport. What do you reckon is fueling it all?
Well, that's difficult to say, but it is good to see you, Carl. Unfortunately, you know, we shouldn't have to be talking about these types of incidents in sport. You know, and this is something that's occurred after the match, as I read, late last night. It seems to be a kind of organised in a way, and I see the Barala Bears have come out and said last night that actually they had warned the team at the start of the season, or teams in their club, that this would not be condoned, and they take a zero tolerance policy. And I think that's the most important thing here, the deterrence for all other players across, whether it's rugby league or in our game, football, or any of the other sports, to understand that this just can't happen. I think I might say, Carl, it's good that it has been filmed, and you know, we saw the violent assault on a referee in our game of football recently. It's important that people are able to document them, because now at least you can have accountability from the police forces, for criminal sanctions, as you say, but also for the club to follow through on that threat. They're talking about pulling the team out. I think that's right. They need to make sure that not only those in their club, but in their league, in their game, and across all sport recognise, mate, that it just can't happen.
Well, it was only 2 months ago, as you rightly point out, with the soccer referee attacked by a fan at another suburban game. I don't know what else we need to do to prevent clashes like this. The punishments need to be more. Do they need to do more to head it off?
Yeah. I think that's right. And you know, sometimes we do see, sadly, that, you know, these people play within club environments, they play within association environments and in local environments, and people can, you know, not at times protect them and you know, ensure that this zero tolerance that we always talk about in sport actually is not real. So these are opportunities for sports, and I see that New South Wales Rugby League, of course, are involved in this this morning, and I've no doubt that they'll take it with the utmost seriousness. Sanctions have to be, you know, have to be extreme, they have to be severe, and the message has to be sent to everyone, mate.
Well, that's the problem, isn't it, that it sends an awful message to kids out there.
Exactly, and everyone at all levels. You know, it was in senior men's, you know, grassroots competition when the referee was attacked. This is also in senior men's competition. So, you know, this is exactly the type of thing where we need to send a message from all of sport right now. Where the sport needs to share that information across sports, and you know, where the rugby league and football and other sports need to get together and ensure that, you know, they share knowledge and make sure that the sanctions are strong enough and that a strong enough approach is being taken. But again, you know, there's the club is involved, there's the association, and then there's the federation, both at state and national, and all of them need to make sure that they do take a zero tolerance policy.
There's plenty of tension out there, isn't there? Good on you, Craig. Thank you so much.